Welcome to another episode of Time to Go. You might be wondering why it's just Pastor Dane this week and no Pastor Justin. Well, while I am here doing this episode of Time to Go here in the freezing cold of Minnesota, it's currently 0 degrees and going to get much colder. Pastor Justin is off getting lost in Florida in probably 60, 70 degree weather. So I told him to get lost a little longer because I'm not really happy with him right now. This week we are focusing on parables of the lost. We're going to hear the story of a shepherd who leaves 99 sheep behind to find one, and a woman who loses one coin out of 10 and rejoices at the end that she found the lost one. At first these seem like feel-good parables. Feel-good stories about how we should all rejoice when something is found. But as we examine them a little closer, we find that there's something more than meets the eye. First, Jesus asks, which one of you wouldn't leave 99 sheep behind to find one? And I think the easy answer is, if you're a shepherd, I wouldn't. Why would I leave 99 sheep to be attacked by wolves, to wander off themselves just to find that stupid sheep that left me, huh? Who would do that? No normal person would do that. And this woman, you know, it makes sense that she'd leave 9 coins behind to find one, but then she throws this giant party that probably costs more than that one coin. Why would she do that? It makes no sense. Why so much joy over these things that were lost? I guess that's the way it works, though, when we lose something we love very much. We do everything we can to find it, and when we find it, we rejoice. Earlier this week, I had the experience of being face-to-face with this kind of parable in my own life. My children got lost one day, and it was one of those really bad panicky feelings. You know, normally my kids are really great kids and they do what I tell them to and they stay where they're supposed to stay. Well, I was looking for them for 10 minutes and then it went to 15 minutes and then 20 minutes and I still hadn't found them, and I was thinking someone might have taken them or whatever, and there they are. Finally, they were hiding, playing a game with me. And at first I wanted to be really angry with them. I wanted to yell at them for being such bad kids. But then I thought about this parable of the shepherd who leaves 99 behind to find one. And what does he do when he finds that one? He rejoices and carries it on his shoulders. I could have chosen to be angry at my lost children, but instead I rejoiced that they were found. This is the kind of silly thing we do when we love something so much or someone so much. We remember that God loves us in this way. God goes to ridiculous lengths to love us and care for us and rejoices when we're found. I hope you remember the love of God that carries you and searches after you, leaving many things behind and rejoicing with you when you're found this week. Remember the love of God that is there, like that shepherd and like that woman, ready to rejoice with you and celebrate with you anytime that you are found. Hope you have a good week, but for now it's time to go. Stay warm.